We have some breaking news coming in. BJP has attacked the Mamata government over Kolkata rape and murder horror. The Mamata government forms a probe panel. BJP trains guns. The BJP says two interns in Mamata government's probe panel. They also say, looking at the composition of the inquiry committee, it is clear that the investigation will be a complete sham, leading to miscarriage of justice. The BJP also says the dark shadow of Mamata Banerjee's hand can be seen all over. That's the latest breaking news we have coming in from Kolkata. The BJP has trained guns on the Mamata government over the horrific rape and murder that's happened in Kolkata. Mamata government has formed a probe panel and the BJP has trained guns on the Mamata government, saying two interns are part of the Mamata government's probe panel. They say, looking at the composition of the inquiry committee, it is clear that the investigation will be a complete sham, leading to a miscarriage of justice. The BJP also says the dark shadow of Mamata Banerjee's hand can be seen all over. This, of course, pertains to the murder that took place in Calcutta in the wee hours of the night, where a trainee doctor was allegedly sexually assaulted and strangulated. And her body was found in a seminar hall in the morning in a hospital. Anirban Roy is joining us live on the broadcast. You know, the fact the murder took place in the wee hours of the night within the hospital premises is quite shocking.
Well, you can see the 24 hours has passed by. One has been detained, and the shocking incident that has happened in RG Kaur Medical College Hospital is the PG second year student, also a junior doctor, who was allegedly murdered and been harassed by some people, and that has been already, the case has been registered, the murder case has been registered. But right now, you can see the doctors, the junior, the senior, every doctors right now in Kolkata of every hospital are protesting against this. Right now you can see behind me that they are all the doctors, those who are giving the break in their work, and right now they are demanding justice for the woman, a doctor, who has already allegedly murdered, and that's why they were protesting. We can see in the live visuals that they have been, they are already given the posters that were written there, that they want the justice for that doctor. I will talk to them. I will try to talk to them. That already we have seen that one people has been detained, and right now, are you all feeling safe in Kolkata and you in your workplaces?
Let the judicial proceedings proceed as they would, but we as a community are feeling very, very unsafe because the hospital security is not yet improved. Our seminar duty rooms, they are non-existent technically. We do not have proper functioning washrooms. So just capturing or arresting one person does not make all that go away. That is still there, and that is still something we need to take care of, and the administration should look into it and find some solution to this, because this cannot go on. What happened yesterday was unbelievable and unacceptable, and we need someone to take
care. Do you think that the investigation that is going on is free and fair, and right now do you have faith in Kolkata police as well as in the West Bengal government?
We do have faith in Kolkata police and the government, and we hope justice will prevail. Regarding the investigation, I am not there. I am not in ground zero. I cannot comment on whatever is going on there. But we just hope that our faith in Kolkata police, since it's there and since it's we have a deep sense of faith in them, I hope that they also help us reach justice that we want. That's it.
I can see that the emotions are running very high, and right now the lady doctors, those who are protesting here, are all because they are scared of the incident. Because what has happened in the RG Kaur Hospital itself, in the Kolkata, in the city of joy, in the heart of the city, the RG Kaur Hospital, that the incident has happened. And after that, everyone is very scared. The doctors are saying that they are scared to go in the workplaces, and they are not feeling safe right now in their workplaces. Over to you.
Right, we'll come back to you for more on this. Adhiranjan Chaudhary is joining us on the broadcast. So, the fact that the murder has taken place in within the hospital premises. It obviously raises some questions against the law and order situation in Bengal, and you know, first and foremost, the security of women in Bengal.
A gruesome incident which had occurred in the Medical College of Kolkata, in Kolkata, where a girl student had been outrageously raped and murdered, is nothing but a glaring example of a deteriorating law and order situation prevailing in West Bengal. It is being amply vindicated that our allegations against the present incumbent in Bengal in regard to the law and order situation has been further vindicated by this kind of gruesome incident. I will appeal to the Chief Minister of West Bengal not to be posed indifferent to this kind of heinous crime by arguing that I am doing something positive, I will take care upon the family, etc. Today the incident took place in medical college. Can you imagine that what is happening in the remote areas of the state of West Bengal? It is not an isolated incident. It is a serial incidence of crimes which involved the criminals, gangsters, and other nefarious elements in our society. Government has to take stringent measures and to restore the confidence of the people of West Bengal as immediately as possible.
Right, sir. Thank you. Thank you for speaking to India Today. I'm going to go back to my colleague Anirban Roy, who's tracking the story. Anirban, have the hospital authorities responded to the protests of the students that are demanding, you know, justice for the student who got murdered? You know, like that such a glaring lapse was committed, and you know, the murder took place inside the hospital premises itself.
Well, the murder has already, we heard of that the murder has happened inside the hospital premises. The body has been found from the seminar hall in the hospital premises. And after that, the Kolkata police is investigating the matter. The Kolkata police has already detained one. And after they were saying that the more people will be coming out after the investigation, as the autopsy report has already already arrived, and after that we can see that the murder case has been already filed by the Kolkata police, has been registered by the Kolkata police as well, and the hospital authority is taking preventive measure after that, as they have said. But right now the people, the doctors, those who are working inside the hospital premises, they are saying that they are not feeling safe, that there is no adequate CCTV arrangements in all the corridors of the hospital, they are alleging. And right now they are very scared of the situation as that has happened inside the hospital premises, as the lady doctors, the women doctors, they are saying that they are not feeling safe right now inside their workplace.
Right. Thank you, Anirban, for giving us all those details. Horrific incident of a PG trainee doctor at Kolkata's government-run RG Carr Hospital, raped and killed, has shocked the nation. There is massive outrage over the death of a 31-year-old trainee doctor. Students took to protest, demanding strictest action in the case. One person has also been detained in the case. Details from the initial autopsy report reveals the horror. According to the 4-page report, there was bleeding from the victim's eyes and mouth. There were injuries all over her face and nail. The victim was also bleeding from her private parts. The victim also had injuries in her belly, left leg, neck, right hand, right finger, ring finger and lips. Reports suggest the victim was first strangulated and then smothered to death. One person has been detained in the case so far in the probe by the SIT. Meanwhile, students led a massive protest demanding the strictest action in the case. The BJP also protested, saying the law and order has completely collapsed in Bengal under Mamata's rule.
আমরা সুবিচার চাই, সুবিচার চাই। তা আমার মেয়েকে আমাদের সন্দেহ ধর্ষণ করে খুন করা হয়েছে। সব রকম হোক, যাই হবে, ন্যায় বিচার হোক, কি হবে না এখন এই সমস্ত আমরা বলতে পারছি না।
মেয়েকে তো আর খুঁজে পাবে না,
যাই গেছে আমাকে আমার যা গেছে সে কেউ দেবে না। সুতরাং এই ব্যাপার নিয়ে আমি আর কোনো কথা বলবো না। সেটা তখন পুলিশ খুব বাজে ব্যবহার করেছে, আমাদের গাড়িটাকে মেরে আবার গাড়িটা আমার ঠেলে ঠেলে আমাদের গাড়ি পার করছে।
যে গোটা পশ্চিমবঙ্গ দুষ্কৃতীদের দখলে চলে গেছে, ফলে এখনই যে ঘটনা পরেন ওই ঘটনা ঘটার পর যা কিছু ঘটে চলেছে প্রশাসনের পক্ষ থেকে, আমাদের মনে হচ্ছে কোনো না কোনোভাবে যে এই একে ধামা চাপা দেওয়ার একটা প্রচেষ্টা, এটাকে আত্মহত্যা বলার একটা প্রচেষ্টা। অথচ মানে সত্যিকারে তদন্ত করে সেই তদন্তে দোষীদের শাস্তি দেওয়ার কোনো উদ্যোগ প্রশাসনের আছে বলে আমাদের মনে হচ্ছে না।
দেখি ম্যাডাম, जो इंसिडेंट हुआ है अचिकर में, ये अत्यंत दुखजनक है। ये लड़की मेरा लड़की जैसी है, इसके साथ हुआ क्या वो तो पोस्टमार्टम रिपोर्ट के बाद ही पता चलेगी। लेकिन ये बोल सकता हूँ, एज ए प्रिंसिपल, एज ए हेड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, आई हैव टेकन ऑल नेसेसरी स्टेप्स रिगार्डिंग इंक्वायरी एंड एवरीथिंग इज डूइंग प्रॉपरली। एज ए प्रिंसिपल आई वॉन्ट द रिपोर्ट शुड कम एज फर्स्ट एंड The culprit should get punished. This much I can say.
शाम के वक्त के बाद आप पोस्टमार्टम नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन यहाँ पर ये लोग पोस्टमार्टम कर रहे हैं, ये हमको सुनने में आ रहे हैं। हम लोग चाहते हैं कि परिवार ये बोले कि वो प्रिजर्व करे बॉडी, और कल हम लोग केंद्रीय सरकार के कोई अस्पताल से पोस्टमार्टम करेंगे, क्योंकि यहाँ का ये सरकार का स्टेट सिस्टम से अगर पोस्टमार्टम हो तो जो सच्चाई है वो फिर से दब जाएगा, ये हमारा पूरा विश्वास है।